This section should give a short introduction to the limitations of AIS system and operator attention to possible AIS limitations. The officer of the watch, OOW, should always be aware that other ships, in particular leisure craft, fishing boats, and warships, and some coastal shore stations, including vessel traffic service, VTS centers, might not be fitted with AIS. The officer on watch should always be aware that other ships fitted with AIS as mandatory carriage requirement might switch off AIS under certain circumstances by professional judgment of the master. Switching off of the AIS may make it more likely that the ship will be checked out, leading to unnecessary inspections. Since pleasure crafts and other small vessels are not required to carry AIS, and the AIS may be switched off or out of order on vessels required to carry AIS, the officer on watch must always be aware that the traffic information provided by AIS may not give a complete picture about the situation around own ship. The officer on watch must always be aware that transmission of erroneous information entails a risk to other ships as well as their own. The users remain responsible for all information entered into the system, as well as the information added by the sensors. This means that the operator must check the own ship AIS information at regular intervals and whenever he suspects that something is amiss. The accuracy of the AIS information received is only as good as the accuracy of the AIS information transmitted. That is, the AIS information presented on your display may vary in quality, depending on the quality of the information transmitted from each ship. The officer on watch should be aware that poorly configured or calibrated ship sensors, position, speed, and heading sensors, might lead to incorrect information being transmitted. Incorrect information about one ship displayed on the bridge of another ship could be dangerously confusing. If no sensor is installed, or if the sensor fails to provide data, the AIS automatically transmits the not available message. However, the built-in integrity check cannot validate the contents of the data process. It would not be prudent for the officer on watch to assume that the information received from other ships is of a comparable quality and accuracy to that which might be available on own ship. The potential of AIS as a collision avoidance device is recognized, and AIS may be recommended as such a device someday soon. However, great care must be taken, as AIS may not give a complete traffic overview or accurate enough information about some or all of the relevant targets. When AIS information is used to assist in collision avoidance decision-making, the following cautionary points should be borne in mind. AIS is an additional source of navigational information. It does not replace, but supports, navigational systems such as radar, ARPA, and VTS. The use of VTS does not negate the responsibility of the officer on watch to comply at all times with the call reg. The user should not rely on AIS as the sole information system, but should make use of all relevant safety information available. The use of AIS on board ship is not intended to have any special impact on the composition of the navigational watch, which should continue to be determined in accordance with the Seafarer's Training, Certification, and Watchkeeping Code, STCW. Once a ship has been detected, AIS can assist in tracking it as a target. By monitoring the information broadcast by that target, its actions can also be monitored. Changes in heading and course are, for example, immediately apparent, and many of the problems common to tracking targets by radar, namely clutter, target swap as ships pass close by, and target loss following a fast maneuver, do not affect AIS. AIS can also assist in the identification of targets by name call sign and ship type and navigational status. VTS centers may send information about vessels which are not carrying AIS and which are tracked only by VTS radar via the AIS to vessels equipped with AIS. Particular care should always be taken when using information that has been relayed by a third party. Accuracy of these targets may not be as complete as actual directly received targets. VTS centers may send short messages either to one ship, all ships, or ships within a certain range or in a special area, such as navigational warnings, traffic management information, port management information. Differential Global Navigation Satellite System corrections may be sent by VTS via AIS. This can increase the accuracy of the GPS-derived data on ships within AIS range. AIS may be used in search and rescue operations, especially in combined helicopter and surface searches. AIS allows the direct presentation of the position of the vessel in distress on other displays, such as radar or ECS ECDIS, which facilitates the task of search and rescue, SAR, crafts. For ships in distress, not equipped with AIS, the on-scene coordinator, OSC, could create a pseudo-AIS target. AIS, when fitted to selected fixed and floating aids to navigation, can provide the following information to the mariner: position, status, tidal and current data, weather and visibility conditions. AIS will play a role in an overall international maritime information system, supporting voyage planning and monitoring. This will help administrations to monitor all the vessels in their areas of concern and to track dangerous cargo. After the September 11th events, authorities in the U.S. and the EU envision an important role for AIS in the field of higher security systems.